All right, here we go. Episode 2 of Trilogy Lacrosse Theater. Ryan, thanks for carving out a little time.
Oh, Mitch, you know, you spend your rookie year with the Titans and, you know, wet behind your ears, and then you head up to Boston, and this is what we have to look forward to, just you turning into a total cyborg.
Yeah, so we are looking at 2009 Boston Blazers highlights, the inaugural season. I'm wearing my New York Riptide shirt just by chance. So I thought it was fitting. And then even more fitting, I was down in the basement playing hockey with my three-year-old, which is, you know, most of my days. And he pulled this guy out.
Nice.
So fired up that I've still got the Boston Blazers jersey ready to go.
You need that on your body right here. I don't know.
That should help me get into character, I think.
Well, I'm just saying, somehow we got this highlight video and they elected, you know, let's just put him in pads but not have a jersey on.
So right.
Editorial selection.
It was probably a Reebok sponsored highlight tape. They got to make sure to get the pads in there.
All right, let's do it. Let's see what we got here.
All right, and at any time, you know, let me know if you want me to pause. I'm going to turn the volume down a little bit. There's some, like, classic, you know, rock and roll song that's probably license-free, so it's not very good.
That's illegal. That's illegal. I mean, you just, like... How are you not getting, like, just teed up right now?
The best part is that's the number one play on my highlights. It's just borderline slew-footing a guy against the board.
From the side, maybe.
I think that's legal. That was a bit of a flop, if you ask me. Okay.
All right. Let's not gloss on. Let's keep moving along here. Look, I love the kid's eyes right here. This face looking down at the he's definitely chirping him.
This guy's dead.
And Cosmos, that's a little pick.
Nice pick there by Anthony Cosmo, too. I'll take it and then get that ball out of my stick as quick.
Off the races.
That doesn't look bad.
Remember when those were a thing? Thundersticks? Thank God that fad died.
Did it?
I haven't watched baseball in years.
I'll tell you what, there's no Thundersticks being clapped this week, unfortunately. This inaugural season, they did pretty well filling the barn at the Garden. We got a pretty
ladies' night. Was this ladies' night?
If it's not, then they certainly flock together in this section.
This might be a second.
Okay, this is just me getting beat, pure and simple, and then I'm not proud of what happens at the end of it. I may have accentuated falling on.
Well, you're doing what you're talking to, right?
This is a murderer's row here. We've got Paul Dawson.
I see that, but who's on the wings? Who's the lefty that went underneath?
I think. Oh, on the stealth.
Oh, is this the stealth?
This is the stealth.
Oh, it's the stealth. Okay.
Sorry. Yeah, I'm not sure who goes underneath. We got Bubba Durno, number 12.
Oh, yeah.
Greg Harnett, and we've got Paul Dawson. That's a crew that I am not going to have to drop the gloves very often because there's plenty of guys that will be beating me to that punch.
And of course, you got Cosmo, Cos right here in the middle, just totally hamming it up. Just love it. Just love it.
Look into the ref. Just come on.
He's already got his palms up. Man.
I'm just happy. I'm happy. You know? I'm happy about it.
Just like the casual.
Now, this gets into – so this is interesting.
This was bad. This is bad. This put me in a tough spot. This is against us. This is –
So this, I believe, is the home opener for the Blazers. So this is the inaugural game for the expansion franchise in Boston, which is half of where I grew up. against the team that didn't protect me in the expansion right. draft. So
I'm on the bench right now. I'm on the boards. This was tough. This was tough.
This is your current boss, Patty Merrill, with the
yep, it's right. Yep,
that's yeah. happy about it. Although I feel like he immediately looks up.
A lot of palms up after Mitch Belisle hits. A lot of palms up. Yeah. I'm gonna just bite my tongue and move along. San Diego Seals for life here.
Who is that in the middle just getting massacred?
Oh, look at that. They got Belisle shirts ready to go.
They sold both of them. They got them.
Is that what relative is that? Is that a nephew?
I think those were homemade, actually. They were like those printing.
Well, bite your tongue, because I actually did have nieces and nephews come to a Cannons game, and they had homemade shirts. They didn't buy Boyle shirts, they homemade them.
That's more impressive. That's shout out to Jude.
That's a theater episode coming down the road, potentially.
Who was that inside on the power?
I'm not gonna say it because he's gonna reappear later in this video. So we're just gonna stick to one comment, not two.
Got it.
Yeah. Oh, a goal?
This play, the Morgan brothers, first of all, for anyone who doesn't know NHL history, the Morgan brothers are like some of the best guys ever. But what a crazy story. 6'7", I think, 6'8", and 6'9", three brothers. One of them played at West Virginia, I believe, basketball. They're all basketball guys. I don't think they had a ton of lacrosse background.
No, Dad was an oak tree.
Yeah, just absolute giants. And there's another video we'll probably do later of when I was on the Titans with you, us against Jackson, Portland Lumberjacks, and those guys played for them too. And just there was one or two where you saw I just ran full speed into one of the Morgans there, and the only thing that happened is the ball came out. He didn't even move.
Are you hearing all these dings on my end?
Do you hear? Yeah, is that you or me?
That's me.
Very popular. I just assume you're so popular.
That's a Philadelphia garbage text thread that's, you know what, 15 years old, that's just lively right now.
Well, we've got Barrage versus Riptide on tap, so we're trying to get the band back together for one of the next Trilogy Lacrosse Theaters. We could probably get a 10, 12 person commentary going.
Yeah. All right, let's see this near pipe Barry right here.
Yes. Big fake.
Huge celebration.
Huge fist bump. Who's that goalie? Dietrich Digger? Digger? He was a long time.
I just want the fist pump. I'm here for the fist pump. I don't even care because I got my
revenge. Oh, yeah.
I wish we could. We don't have that kind of effects with this highlight. I mean, this is. I don't know how to do it. I'm not ready to do it, folks.
Hannah's in the other room. But
keep going. Just keep going. Just keep going. Just keep
going. Wait, just wait. They show two angles of it. They don't show a third angle of it, mostly because I threw the ball into the corner. No one caught that.
Why did Steve Toll commit to you? Wrong side, like. Steve Toll, if you're out there or if somebody else is out there, show this to Steve Toll right here. Just a beauty. Old salty veteran that taught me how to play. Steve Toll, he commits to you. Wrong side. Poor decision, Toller.
Toller is also one of the best at picking off passes.
No. Not one of the best. The best. The best.
So that behind the back, it went approximately to no one. So I think that's why he went for it, because he knew that was the only option I had, and I just threw it in the corner. So they show that replay, the behind-the-back replay, twice, but you don't see what happens on the other end because the ball goes rolling into the corner. There might not even have been a person.
Oh, they did show it. Okay.
No, that was another play. That was just poor shot placement by yours truly right here.
Oh, they part of your highlight tape is a shot that doesn't end in a goal.
It's probably my only shot of the season. That's why.
Here's a highlight. Took a shot. This is a part of the Jack Reed highlight tape that just got somehow mixed in.
It was a nice feed there. He really threaded the needle there. Not close
enough to a highlight. Close enough.
They show it again. They show it a second.
Hey, guys. Oh, no.
Yeah, the one that'll live on in infamy.
Yeah, this is like your version of the Kyle Hartzell rusty gate, but yours is positive and mine's negative. This is probably,
but I still take a lot of heat for you know the jump at the end instead of just going for the ball.
Yeah.
But that said, I went right to the bench and we got our
again. You're coming out of the penalty box. This was a tough one for me to have to live between two ferns.
And again, this was the inaugural opener for the Blazers. So the fans, all my friends from high school were there. The fans got into it. They were certainly all about it.
So this is part of your defense right here. This is the home opener.
You know, I was scorned, lovered, kicked off of the Titans, unprotected.
And well, regardless, the people have seen this. If they haven't, they can find it. There's another replay coming, so we got to keep going.
Probably should have just kept going.
Time heals all wounds.
It's true. I think everyone's, you know, everyone's better and wiser for it.
Time heals all wounds. Side gaze is just straight out of an 80s movie. It's just so awesome. It's like the classic, like, early aughts, like, video production, like, I know what you'll do. You won't be looking at us, and then you will be looking at us.
Well, and you know, these...
Here's another one.
I was just going to say, these photo and video shoots, or the poses, like, okay, try maybe to stick behind the shoulders. Now point with the stick. It's like, what else can you do? I want you to ride it like a broom, like a witch. Maybe churn some butter up.
We need, this is a good brainstorm. We need to come up with some new like lacrosse stick kind of poses, like this one, you know, this like, it is.
The rifle on the shoulder maybe, like.
Yeah. Yeah, we need to come up with some more. Or like, just go with it and, like, let's start breaking it over our knee. Oh. And then, like just get a disposable one and, like, ka-ka, you know, and then, like, some of that, you know? Or, like over your head and it just, like, bends, you know? Like,
I'm on board.
Okay, well.
The Bo Jackson.
Yeah.
I think that's the gauntlet has been laid down. The challenge is there to everyone watching. Give us your best pose with a lacrosse stick that you would do on your card, right? I'll also take your worst. And then the look, right? There's this. That's about it. That's all there's we got.
The full, like, I'm showing you my back, and then I do like the 180. So like.
I'm pretty sure that's the Dr. Evil that you just did.
Oh, good Lord.
All right. Well, episode 2, a little bit shorter, I think probably for the best. Matt Strebel is supposed to be on this one again. So he's like, you know, Jimmy Kimmel and Matt Damon. Just we're going to keep saying he's supposed to be on. He's never going to be on. He's just slowly crisscrossing the country in his family caravan.
I got you, Streebs. We'll get you next time.
And then hopefully, you know, we'll get some good guests. We've put the feelers out there. We got a lot of interest, some celebrities, some lesser known names, some people that are going to be highlighted in some of the videos, but excited excited to keep this thing rolling, and thanks for spending another nice night with us.
Yeah, if you're still watching by now, you've been watching a black screen for like a minute, so God bless you.
Yeah, the tech aspect, still working on that part. So, all right. Thanks, Ry.